Hi, I'm Cathy Fang, and I'm presenting Retargeted Self-Haptics for Increased Immersion in VR Without Hand Instrumentation. This work was done at the Future Interfaces Group at Carnegie Mellon with Professor Chris Harrison. Current VR systems provide immersive graphics and audio, but physical touch feedback remains very limited. Most consumer systems today use handheld controllers, which only provide vibration feedback. Some consumer systems provide controller-free interactions, preferring not to encumber the user's hands, but as a consequence, cannot deliver any haptic feedback. Thus, a large body of research has developed solutions that are handheld, such as haptic links, or directly instrument the hands, such as virality. Another body of research looking into contactless haptics using air vortexes, such as aerial, or ultrasonic phased arrays, such as Ultra Leaps, Stratos Explore, to deliver tactile sensation akin to a tap on the skin. Prior work has also considered the use of manual labor or human-generated actions to provide haptic feedback. These approaches either prevent freehand interactions or cannot simulate feedback from grasps, or require other humans to achieve the haptic feedback, which motivated our research question. Could we repurpose the user's own body to provide haptic feedback and allow for freehand interactions? We present our technique called retargeted self-haptics, which I will explain with an example. Here a user places their hand onto a palm scanner, which then causes a keypad to flip open. In a typical VR experience, both hands will feel nothing interacting with these virtual elements. However, by manipulating the positions of the virtual hands, what is known as haptic retargeting, we can subtly guide a user's hands together. Now, when the user types on a keypad, they feel an actual physical surface. Haptic retargeting, also known as redirected touch, utilizes visual dominance and temporal coincidence to change how virtual objects are perceived. For example, the user sees that the virtual hand touches three separate virtual cubes, when in reality, they touch the same physical cube. Most related to our work and the least explored is self-haptics, which is haptic feedback touching one's own body. Coley introduced the concept of the haptic hand, where a virtual touch interface overlays on top of the non-dominant hand. In air haptics, Ben et al. Pioneered the idea of warping the thumb and index finger to create pinching and pulling sensations for virtual objects. We built our approach on top of the body warping retargeting techniques, but instead of using physical props, we warp the hands of a user such that they come into contact with one another in a purposeful way in order to achieve a design haptic feedback. Note that in the scanner and keypad example, only one hand receives appropriate haptic feedback, even though this is a two-handed task. We define appropriate haptic feedback as when the magnitude and direction of forces approximate the real-world action. We use these two dimensions to form an interaction design space to guide our explorations. The palm scanner and keypad example goes in the upper right quadrant. Other examples in this category include striking a match, where only the hand holding the match receives appropriate resistance, hammering a nail, where the hammering hand is halted appropriately, and cutting vegetables, where again the cutting hand is stopped at the cutting board. It is also possible to have two-handed tasks where both hands receive coordinated physical feedback. We built a number of illustrated examples, including this bow and arrow demo, where the user's thumb is retargeted to the bow string, allowing the user's hands to exert opposing pulling forces as will be experienced under a real bow and attention. Here the user can physically feel when the ammunition magazine has been fully inserted by warping the hand positions. In this example, the palm is retargeted to act as a phone screen, and taps to the phone screen exert a downward force on the holding hand. Similarly, the impact from hitting a baton in the hand can now be felt. Not all interactions require both hands, and so we also explored self-haptics for one-handed tasks. As there is only one hand present to receive haptic feedback, the bottom left of our design space is not applicable. While we did consider how a single hand could provide haptics for itself, we found the design space to be much richer when the unused hand was appropriated as an accessory prop. For example, here a user is presented with a red launch button. Typically in VR, the user will just reach out and pull at it with no haptic feedback. With our approach, a translucent hand is also rendered in a scene, which turns green when the user matches the position and pose. Now, with a dominant hand, the user can reach out to perform the one-handed interaction and receive some haptic feedback. In this example interaction, a thumb is used as a prop for a mixing whisk. Here, the unused palm allows the user to rest their finger on a virtual fingerprint scanner. And finally, the palm again allows the user to physically knock on this door. In the paper, we provide a table of specific retargeting parameters for all our demos, as well as open-sourced several examples for people to try. We conducted a user study with 11 participants who tried two examples out of each category where one or both hands receive feedback for a one or two-handed task, and in both conditions, no haptic feedback or with self-haptics. We found that all three categories in the self-haptic condition represented as blue bars were rated higher in tactility than in a no-haptic condition, represented as red bars, while having no significant effect on either ownership or agency. Similarly, all three categories in the self-haptic condition were rated higher for immersion, realism, and fun. And among them, the leftmost blue bar, which represents the category of bimanual tasks where both hands receive feedback, was rated the highest. Overall, the category that participants preferred the most is the one where both hands receive feedback during a bimanual task, in which appropriate feedback was provided to both hands while making minimal modification to the action itself. In addition to the questionnaire results, we gather insights from combining participants' think aloud and observations. For example, we observed that impact-oriented interactions that are short and fast perform better, and scenarios involving a smaller contact area, such as a fingertip landing on the palm, perform better than warping a hand around the thumb. Our technique faces tracking and precision in the current computer vision-based approach, which affects realism. To mitigate errors, we suggest designers choose target surfaces that are harder to miss and more forgiving, rather than smaller body features or surfaces with irregular geometries. We also identified five factors that are key to identifying the body part best suited to convey a haptic effect, such as size, contour, and anchoring. Anecdotally, we also observed potential psychophysical effects, such as haptic valence and somatosensory attenuation, which poses interesting questions for future work. Our technique is not suitable for all interactions, such as training tasks that require high position and haptic details. Only using parts of the hand and arm has a limited surface area and a limited palette of textures and compliance, which inherently feels different from common objects. As mentioned in the previous slide, our technique involves partial hand occlusion, which causes poor hand tracking. Thus, we avoided heavy occlusion and freezes the hand in place in case of a tracking loss. Our technique utilizes visual haptic mismatches, which is unexpected, and the category where the undominant hand is used as a prop is inherently less intuitive. But we found all participants were able to quickly acquaint themselves with the shifted position after a brief period. For the scope of our project, we only looked into retargeting arm and hands. Future research could look into other body parts and features for repurposing, as well as retargeting the fingers such that the hand provides haptic for itself. Please see the paper for more details. Thank you.